Hello, I'm Alberto Ross from the University of Murcia, and I'm going to present speculative enforcement of store atomicity, work done with Stefanos Kaxiras from Uppsala University. I'm going to talk about memory consistency models and their trade-off between programmer intuitions and performance. In this work, we take IBM 370, a consistency model that is stronger than x86 TSO and therefore more intuitive, and study the limits of in-window speculative execution. The result is an efficient implementation of the IBM 370 model with similar performance than x86 TSO and at a low complexity and hardware cost, just 8 bytes. We'll start motivating the work, then present our speculative solution, brief evaluation, terminology, and finally conclude the work. The memory consistency model defines the behavior of the programs, what a value a load will get, and what a value a store will write to memory, with two rules. First is the ordering rules with respect to program order, or PO. So if in a program we have a load followed by another load in program order, and this load, the first load, performs, get the value before this load, we will say that we respect, or the consistency model respects, the load-to-load order. The same for a load followed by a store followed by a load, or a store followed by a store. These four rules can summarize the ordering rules of the consistency models. But it's not only ordering rules. As Arvin and Maesen mentioned in their RISC-V6 paper, memory model is equal instruction reordering plus store atomicity. That means that it's also important when stores are visible to other threads. And this is the key difference between the two models that we explore in this work. x86 TSO is a total store order model employed by the x86 processor and relaxes the store to load order. We put it here more light. So it's enforced load, 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 store, and store to store order, but lacks structural order. And regarding atomicity, a core can see its own stores before other cores. This is done through store to load forwarding. That means there is a store that has not written the data yet to the cache, to the memory, and a following load targeting the same address can get the data from the store, can see the value of the store before it's written to memory, and therefore before other cores can see it. IBM 370, implemented by the IBM Z architecture series, has the same ordering rules as x86 TSO, but differs in atomicity. Here, all cores see all stores atomically. So this is a more intuitive consistency model, but is less performant, mostly if we restrict completely the store to load forward. So why is less intuitive x86 TSO? We develop a tool that can be found here to detect x86 TSO behaviors that are forbidden by IBM 7. We found, details are in the paper, that x86 TSO, order loads can see order stores in a different order as they appear in a program. That means that either the load order is broken or the store. Also, order loads can disagree about the order of independent stores. Two stores written by different threads and two pairs of loads by two threads, this pair of loads cannot agree in which store happened before. One pair can say that one store happened before and the other can say that the other store happened before. And this makes less intuitive the atomicity. But IBM 370 is less performant than x86 TSO. Our evaluation, when we remove or we disallow store to load forwarding, show that parallel application degrades performance by 27%. So can we have both intuition and performance? Yes, in the paper we will show that with a novel speculative solution for store to load forwarding, we can get both. So we'll start the solution step by step. First, we like to show what is the performance of forbidden completely load to load, store to load, sorry, forwarding, normalized with x86 TSO that allows store to load forwarding. So we'll be here. If IBM 370, if we don't do speculation at all, we just forbid load forwarding, we get plus 27% execution time in parallel applications and plus 23 in sequential. But we can take the speculative techniques proposed by Karasorlu et al. In their ICPT paper, targeting sequential consistency, and can be adapted to our IBM 370 model. How can we adapt these speculative techniques? This way. So all loads execute speculatively, even the ones that get the value forwarded from the stores. Speculative loads will be squashed if they are caught. That means that an invalidation or an eviction from the cache matches the address of the speculative load. And loads will be speculative, that means cannot retire from the processor, until the store buffer drains. This SC technique adapted to IBM 370 gives us a lot of extra performance for parallel applications, but still we have a 14% increase in time for sequential applications. So can we do it better? We have a key finding in this paper, which is that the loads that get the data forwarded from a store do not need to be speculative, in contrast to the SC speculative solution. We call them the source of speculation, or SOS. And subsequent loads to forwarded loads will be speculative. They cannot retire, but forwarded loads, first one in the pipeline, can do. Subsequent loads cannot retire no matter if they are forwarded or not. So we implement this in this way. When a forwarded load retires, it will close what we call the retire gate. So no other load can retire after that. When the store buffer drains, the retire gate will open again. Loads that follow a forwarded load or are resolved while the retire gate is closed will be speculative and will squash if they are caught. With this implementation of this finding, we get 2% extra in execution time, both for parallel and for sequential application. But we are still far from an idea. So the next finding is speculation due to store to load forwarding ends exactly when the forwarding store writes to cache. We don't need to wait for the whole store buffer to be drained. This is because a reordering due to store to load forwarding cannot be observed after the write of the store is done. All course are seeing the value of the store at that time. We have an efficient implementation for this finding along with the previous one. Every forwarded load records the position of the store, the position in the store buffer of the store that forwarded the data. We call that position the key for the gate. When a forwarded load retires, will close the retire gate with its key. That means no other loads, no subsequent loads, can retire until the gate is open. Every store that completes, that is, writes to cache, checks if the key can open the gate. In that case, the store will open the gates and loads will not be speculative anymore because of the gate closed and can retire on the back. With this efficient implementation and this finding, we get our final result of 2.5% for parallel applications and 2.7% extra for sequential applications. We'll show the evaluation. First, the methodology. We employ the sniper simulator that fit an in-house processor model with micro instructions, with microops, and issue memory requests to a Ruby system similar to the one employed by Jet. We model 8 out of order Skylight cores with a load queue of 72 entries, a store queue plus a store buffer of 56 entries, and a reorder buffer of 224 entries. Our parallel benchmarks are the Splash 3 and the Parsec 3.0, and our sequential benchmark are the Spec CPU 2017. I will show a characterization that tells us why we get the results that I saw in the previous section. So out of the total instruction, there are around 24% of loads. And only 3.7% of instructions that are loads that are actually forwarded. And 4.5% in sequential application. That's why in sequential application, having more forwarding, the improvements are less. The gate is stalled only by 1%. So only one out of three of these loads will cross the gate. And the average stall cycles that the gate is closed is 18% for parallel application and 11% for sequential application. Sequential application closes the gate more times, but for less time. Finally, speculative loads and the new speculative loads that we introduce in this world because of store load forwarding are squashed and executed if they are caught. But we found that it's less than 0.5% of instructions, the ones that have to squash or execute because of this. Note that when a load is squashed, all the subsequent instructions to that load are also executed. I want to mention just a brief thing about the terminology. The fact that in x86 TSO, the core see their own stores before the others is mentioned or is named as write atomicity or store atomicity, for example, in the Nagaragan et al. Paper in 2019. We in this work, since there is no terminology in that respect for when all the stores are seen atomically, change slightly the terminology or do a change. So we consider that the write is the action of the store instruction. So the write goes at the cache protocol level and cannot say, the cache coherence protocol cannot say anything about if the own store wants to read the data before. So we call the atomicity of x86 TSO write atomicity. And the one of IBM 370, we don't make it as a synonym of write atomicity, but call it store atomicity because instruction, store instruction are at the processor level. So that's why this paper is called speculative enforcement of store atomicity, which in this paper means the IBM 370 atomicity. So to conclude, we have proposed new speculative techniques for store to load forwarding using simple in-window speculation, never after retirement. We analyze which loads should be speculative and for how long they should be speculative. And we have an efficient implementation that just requires 80 extra bytes. The result is an intuitive and performance implementation of a memory consistency model. And with raise here the question, could this implementation get even better performance? Yes, if store buffer is more efficient, if we boost the store buffer efficiency, stores will write to cache earlier and the retired gate will be closed less time. So if you want to see how we can boost the store buffer efficiency, I invite you to see the next paper in this session. Thank you very much. I will be happy to attend your questions in the session 4A in Micro.